Gude, let's take apart the ID hard drive. If you want an introduction into this 20-year-old technology, I've already made a video about this. It is linked below. But now let's get started with part 2. If you buy your 12 terabytes today for the same price as these 2.5 gigabytes 20 years ago, you will get a hard drive that looks almost like this hard drive. It has the same dimensions. It has different plugs, less plugs there, and a smaller board, of course. But basically, the dimensions and the mounting holes are all the same. Of course, it's secured with these Torx screws. And I think I start with the board at the back. Ooh, hear that? Okay, this is the connector on this side. Okay, it's also January 1997. Okay, and what we got here is... Here is some foam, probably to prevent it from rattling. It's still working fine. It's even a year older than the hard drive itself. Ah, here are the connectors. Ah, nice. So basically this is for the data pin and this is for the motor itself. Warranty void if removed. Let's start with that. But nothing special, it's just a hole. Also 1996. So we have to void the warranty again. The old, old mistake. It's been too long. And here we go. So we have no seal in here because it was sealed by the tape around it. And then this is the hard drive itself. It's beautiful, isn't it? So we have the motor for the spindle with the magnets. You see that it's physically limited to those two positions. Two discs, one upper and one lower disc. And we have four arms, one that is on top, one on bottom, and so on. So when these things spin up, the air will create a cushion and actually lift those tiny reed heads that are there a bit from the surface, and so it doesn't scratch. So right now it's not rotating, therefore we get this nasty noise. But once it's spinning, there will be a cushion of air and it will be floating over the disk. And the problem with the hard drives in general is that you see we have four arms, so basically we would be able to read four times the data of each arm. But since they are linked, you can just get the data at the position, at one position, and not on four individual positions. And since the data most likely is not stored or is not requested in the way that all the arms will be at the right position by default, yeah, the arms have to like scribble around and... Okay, I just connected the power to it and then see what happens. And yeah, that's basically it. You see the arm moving around, trying to get the data. It's really fast, but it's faster to just call the right sector on an SSD. And you see the waste of space, because this is actually the only part of the hard drive that saves your data, or that stores the data. Then you have like a fourth of the space for the read thread and the mechanics. And also, since the disk is round, you also waste the space on this page. One thing I want to show you is this little cushion. It looks like nothing, but we saw that it was a sealed area, but still there could be some dust, or there could be some scrapings from somewhere. And you saw the disk rotates like this, and if it rotates like this, all the air will be pushed in this direction, and some of it will hit this little cushion, and all the debris or dust or whatever will be caught in here and not, in the worst case, messing up the read threads. These screws are really, really tight. It's also glued in there. There's a seal down here. Yeah, and this is just held back by the magnets again. Stop buffer. The end of the read head will hit against to make it stop. Basically just a coil And underneath is a big magnet, probably neodymium or something like this. Yes. Now we can, exactly. This would have been the elegant way. And here we have the reed heads. So you see the reed heads and the cables going there to get the data. One for the top and one for the bottom. And then it just goes down into this piece, which probably is just an amplifier. The disc will rotate from here to there. So it will come like wee. Down here is the actual magnet. Exactly. It's really, really strong. What is left is to get the actual discs with the data and the motor. And then we're done. So it's really secure because those discs are spinning at 5000 or 7200 APM. And here we come. We just have the spacer and then the disc. Really pretty because it's so clean. Another spacer. And this is actually the motor. And you can have lots of fun with this. Okay, don't want to get you bad ideas. And that's the motor. You see, that's the only thing that's left. One piece and the end of our journey, I think. But that's it. That was the hard drive. Thanks a lot for watching.